Now we are going to establish communication between the parent and child in such a way that now child will send data to the server, to the parent. Before we have seen the decorated at the rate input where parent is sending data to the child. Now we are sending data from the child to the parent. So how we will do that? So for that, first of all, we have to create a parent and child relation. So let us create two component. In this case, let me create a two parent child relationship like doctor and patient. Doctor and patient. I think we have created doctor component. Okay, we have created. So let us take. So let us create a parent component and the generate component company. It is created. And after the creation of company component, go inside it and create another component that will be ng generate component, and it will be employee emp. Now we have two component, one is the company, another is the child. Second step is that first of all paste the selector of company component inside the app.component.html. go here, copy the ts file here, copy this particular selector and then paste it inside the app.component.html. I am going here and inside removing everything and pasting this. Now if you open this particular our site, then you can see that company works is coming. Now what we have to do, we have to send something from child to parent. So let us go to the child. In our case it will be employee, or you can see employee want to say something to the company, something like that. So I am going inside the company component. Where is company? This company component. Inside company component we have the employee component. Let us go here and go to the HTML. If you want to send some data from child to parent, there should be some event there. Either you are clicking some button, you are checking some checkbox, you are changing radio. There should be some event triggering on your child component so that it will emit something and it will go to the parent. So I am here. Now let me create a button. Button class. Button class, and I am putting here button dash primary, because we have already applied the bootstrap CSS here, and I am putting here fire. As a very easy example I am giving you, I have a button fire to the parent component, and let me to bind one event here that will be the click event equal to fire message. Because we are doing the event binding here, so we have to define this particular function inside the employee.component.ts. We are doing everything inside the child component. Now earlier we are getting something from parent through @ input. Now we are emitting something to the parent. Sending means in programming world it is the event emitter. We are emitting something to the parent. For emitting something, first of all we have to use event emitter, and this time the decorator that we will use is @output, fine. @output. So as we bind the click event, so this is our own event, we are creating our own event. So let us take the get message. Let us get msg is the event object we are initializing equal to new event emitter. New event emitter that is of generic type string. Okay, got one expected zero type argument. Here we have this is a data member of the class. But this is not a normal data member of the class, this is AK47 in itself. Because this data member get initialized with event emitter, and event emitter object can be able to emit the events. We have to send something to the parent, so we have to emit something. Normal data member of string type cannot be able to emit anything. Only a data member of type event emitter can be able to emit either string value or number value or object value. So I have created data member. So once I click on the button on the HTML, this function gets called, and then this dot dot emit. What emit? I want to emit some string value. Hello, parent company. Perfect. So we have created a simple HTML. Here we have clicked. We have created a button. We have applied the event binding. On button click, we are invoking the fire message. We are defining this fire message inside the component class, and we want to emit something. But data member that we are creating should not be of a string type, not be of number type, it should be of event emitter type, because an object of event emitter can only be emit the event. Now let us, so what is this? This is the event actually we are emitting. So go to the parent component, and the parent component is this one, right? I am going here and trying to invoke the child component app-emp inside there. Now recently we have created an event inside it. So to bind the event, we have to use this small bracket. And the name of event that we have created, that is actually triggering, that is actually emitting the event, that is getMSG. So I have to put here getMSG. And getMSG equal to what? GetMSG equal to now. So suppose I'm just trying to refer it with a normal example. Suppose we have created a button tag, suppose. So this is a click event, that is ready-made click event. Like value property binding we are using earlier, that is ready-made property binding, and we are creating our own property. Likewise, this is the ready-made event that we are binding, and this is the main-made. Or the programmer, this is the event made by us. So what we do? Once we click on this, we are invoking show or anything. So if we are creating this button inside this company.component.html and we have bind click event, then we have to define show inside the company.component.ts. So this is the this click event, if I'm invoking this show method, so this is the HTML of component dot com, this is the HTML of component.component.html. So this method should be defined inside component.component.ts. Likewise, get message, forget where we have defined the event. Of course, we have defined this particular event inside the employee component, but think it as a click event. So if we have clicked this particular thing, then I want to call any method that is present inside the, so I need to create this function inside this component.component.ts. Like for click, we are creating this show method inside component.component.ts. So for any event binding, if I am creating my custom, I am calling my custom function, this custom function should be inside the company.component.ts. Go to the company.component.ts and go here, and here what that event contains, it contains whatever we are emitting from the child component. There we are emitting some string value, hello parent company, something like that. So event is, I am putting as data, anything, data. Right? Now, what thing I want to do? Child is emitting something, button is inside child component.
I am emitting towards the parent, and now here we are inside parent component. Here this is the parent component, and finally we are getting data here inside the parent component. Now I want to bind it to the parent HTML. Parent HTML. Then as simple we know that we can create a data member. So private message from child. There is a beautiful message from the child. It's a string type. So what we will write here? This dot message from child equal to data that actually we are getting from the child component. Now going toward this, once you click on this particular button, already parent got that particular message. So I am putting here this one. Got my point? Because this is the HTML of parent. This is the HTML component dot component HTML is the parent component HTML. Go to this particular browser. Okay. Where it is? Node modules source labs. Earlier it was not coming. Why it is coming now? Let me to go to component dot component dot TF. Maybe by mistake we have included somewhere. Event emitter is not from the this one, it should be at the rate angular slash core. Fine. Now it's working fine, perfect. But here we are seeing only company works. Why? Let me to write. Okay, let us go to the inspect it. Go to the console. Oh my god, no error is coming. But go to this one, here also no error is coming. Then what is the problem? Okay, so here we can see that something wrong. Let us go to the app component to component TS. Okay, see, we have initialized this message from child, so we have to go here and we have to paste it down. Now go here and you can see fire. We are firing from the child component and it is going to the parent. On parent component, going to the parent dot component dot TS or company dot component dot TS. From that, we are initializing the template of the parent. So from child component, we are sending some message and displaying over the parent component HTML.